Hey, Ben here. In this video, a topic that just keeps on giving, Energy Systems 3 will cover more numbers concerning calories burned from fats and from carbohydrates, and how we can better understand and use the calculator that I provided to you in the Fit 50 Calorie Activity Calculator tutorial. In that video, it's in the description. Check it out. This final energy systems discussion will hopefully convince you that a high intensity approach to exercise provides you a better overall calorie burn of our targeted energy source, carbohydrates, but also fat as well. Let's take a look at it.
Traditionally, it's been said that if you want to lose a pound of unwanted body weight, you would need to exhaust around 3,500 kcals in energy from the body's stored substrates of carbohydrates, fats, and proteins. A kilocalorie, or a large calorie, is a nutritional energy equivalent and is based on the amount of heat required to raise the temperature of 1 kilogram of water by 1 degree Celsius. Every food has a caloric equivalent because all food has molecular bonds of carbon, oxygen, and hydrogen that, when broken, release energy that can be synthesized by the body to make adenosine triphosphate, which is required to initiate muscle contraction. In the laboratory, these food molecules can be broken by burning the food in a bomb calorimeter, and the resulting heat can be measured in kilojoules to estimate how much potential energy the food could provide to the body. 1 kcal is equivalent to about 4.184 kilojoules of heat energy. Once in the body, food is digested into its smallest molecular components, which are used for immediate energy needs or stored for future energy demands. About 10% of our food energy is used for digestion itself. Another 20% of the food energy is used for direct physical activity. The remaining 70% of the food consumed is used for all the remaining functions of the body. This 70% demand is known as our basal metabolic rate, or BMR, and it's essentially all the calories that we would need for base survival if we were in a comatose state. Through laboratory tests, it's been determined that a gram of pure rendered fat will provide about 9 kcals worth of potential energy for the body to use, while a gram of carbohydrate or protein will only provide about half the energy at 4.5 kcals each. After adolescence, body fat is said to make up the majority of the weight our bodies gain. Fat pounds then seem to be our problem ever after. So how much does a pound of fat weigh versus a pound of protein or carbohydrate? Well, a pound is a pound, or 453.592 grams. The better question is, how many kcals of energy of these macronutrients would you need to exhaust to remove one of those pounds of body weight? Math time. 453.592 grams times 9 kcals of fat means it would possibly take 4,082.328 kcals to exhaust a pound of pure fat in the body. 453.592 grams times 4.5 kcals of carbs or protein means it would take about 2,041.164 kcals to exhaust a pound of either of those two substrates. Seems high, you say? What about 3,500 kcals for a pound of fat? Just wait. Although considered separate tissues, muscles, fat, nerves, brain, etc., the body is made up of much the same stuff, with every body tissue having a distribution of stored fluid, carbohydrates, fats, and proteins, which are actually just molecular structures mainly made up of carbon, hydrogen, and oxygen atoms. If you search for the numbers for what percent of a fat cell is pure fat, it ranges all over the place, and this is because body composition is dynamic and differs from person to person, situation to situation, and day to day. These numbers are at best guesstimates, but at any given time, roughly 13 to 41% of a fat cell is comprised of proteins, carbohydrates, and the fluid required to bind those substrates into a structure, while the remaining 59 to 87% of the fat cell is actually fat. And that's why calorie math is different inside the body than in a bomb calorimeter inside the laboratory. And this is good news because we're not going to have to burn over 4,000 kcals to reduce our pound of fatty cells. So let's take a look at an example. So let's say today Billy's fat cell has 87% pure fat, 10% carbohydrate, and its associated fluid, which is about 2 to 4 grams of water, and then 3% protein and its associated fluid, which is about 0.02 to 0.05 grams of water. To reduce a pound of these similarly structured fatty cells, Billy would need to exhaust 87% of a pound of lab fat kcals, or 4,082.328. That equals 3,551.625 kcals. Yeah, there's your 3,500 kcals of fat burn that we talked about earlier. But wait, the cell's not completely exhausted yet. Billy also has to exhaust 10% of a pound of lab carbohydrate kcals, or 2,041.164, which equates to 204.116 kcals in the body. 3% of a pound of lab protein also has to be exhausted, which is 2,041.164, or 61.234 kcals inside the body. If we add up all of the kcals expended inside the body, it equals about 3,816.975 kcals to help Billy lose a pound of those fatty cells. Have you noticed that I've been saying exhaust in regard to cell reduction rather than burn? Our bodies are not bomb calorimeters. They do not burn the food we consume. They convert molecular bonds via chemical conversions, forming and reducing them to store and release energy through ionic charge shifts. The remnants of those unbonded molecules are unused atoms of carbon, oxygen, and hydrogen that will form into water and then be secreted from the body as sweat, tears, or urine. The remaining atoms will form into other molecules like pyruvate, lactate, or ketone bodies, which can be used for additional energy. In the end, carbon dioxide is a waste byproduct that is created and breathed from the lungs during exhalation. So essentially, you're breathing off your fat and carbohydrates away from the body as they are converted into energy. I digress. Back to fat cell reduction. So a fat cell is not purely a fat cell. And this means that when you lose a pound of fat, you're also losing a portion of more metabolically active molecules in the form of protein and carbohydrates. And that will begin to trigger metabolism reductions over time. Research has proposed that the more of a body tissue you initially possess before restricting calories, then that's the tissue your body prefers for a calorie source. And this is why a majority of weight loss in the early stages of a restricted calorie program is fat. But as the kcal intake continues downward, fat loss will begin to slow because of fat ratios dropping and metabolic tissue loss triggering metabolic slowing. This is a natural reaction by the body because it's an evolutionary protection mechanism to prevent starvation. Losing fat because there's more fat to lose would kind of make sense if considering supply and demand in economies of scale. If it's more economic to grab an abundant cell, why waste energy going for harder to find energy sources? But in regard to weight loss, fat doesn't exhaust more of itself than the body possesses. There are a lot of overweight people out there that are proof of that. It may be more accurate to consider that the more of a stored energy source that you have, the better the body gets at trying to sustain that energy source. Also, if the body is good at making fat and wants to use it all the time at rest, which is most of the time for inactive people, then why not make more of it? This is where exercise comes in and why Fit 50 advocates higher intensity work.
And how do you reverse this process and get rid of body fat? You've got to work your muscles. You've got to make them burn. You've got to exhaust all that stored carbohydrate that's in there and make the body pull the fat back into the muscle as reserve fuel.
What are the factors in reducing stored sugar in the muscle? Most people don't like the feeling of burning in their muscles and getting out of breath as a result, but both are indicators that sugars are being utilized in the muscle and we're ridding the muscle of excess sugar storage. Okay, I think we firmly established and belabored the fact that the best way to burn fat is not through direct exercise, but during rest, using the fat to replenish carbohydrate depleted muscles. To reduce a pound of fatty cells in the body, we know that the number of calories we need to expend or exhaust is about 3,800 calories plus. Trying to expend 3,800 calories with exercise is very difficult. It'll take several days to expend that number of calories with exercise alone, but your body's basal metabolic rate is continuously expending large numbers of calories. Why not make that more effective? Of course, it's best to know approximately how many calories you're taking in every day for a start, and that's where the calorie counter comes in handy. And also, it's good to know approximately how much you burn every day, and that's where the activity calculator comes in handy. But honestly, if you're spending an excessive amount of time weighing foods and counting calories, sometimes you get lost in the minutiae of all that activity and you forget just the basic thing that you need to do. Work out harder, sweat more, burn those muscles. And honestly, if you look in the mirror and you jump up and down a little bit and anything's shaking, you're probably still fat. And the reason why you're still fat is because you're taking in way too many calories still and you're not exhausting enough calories. And I know you'd like to blame your metabolism or some thyroid condition or a hormone problem, and you may have those things, but also you don't know if adding a little bit more muscle and reducing your caloric intake and increasing your work capacity might help you and correct those problems and reduce your body fat. It's just not fun. And it's not easy, and everyone would like to have it served up to them in the form of a pill. There is no quick fix. It took years to put that body weight on, and it may take some years for it to slowly, constructively come off. And you're going to have to find some discipline along the way. Lack of discipline, too much beer, too many sweets, that got you where you're currently at. You may need to tighten up a little bit and learn to do without those sort of things in order to be able to lose the body fat that you have.
All right, now that you've seen Energy Systems 3, I hope you get a better understanding of why we approach carbohydrates as our targeted fuel source and how that helps us pull fat as a secondary fuel source into our resting muscles to be burned as our primary energy source during rest. All right, more Fit 50 videos to come. Hope you guys are enjoying these and you're staying Fit 50.